Well, not only is this bad policy, but I think the key issue here, and we'd love it respectfully if you guys can ask the White House again, this is purposeful policy. This is purposeful policy. The White House isn't a bunch of dummies. They are purposely driving up prices on Americans for energy. How do we know that? A, just listen to the rhetoric of Gina McCarthy and others, the czars, where they say that limited supply will increase prices and that will, quote, accelerate the transition to renewables. Go ask them. This is purposeful. The second reason we know it's purposeful is just look at the policies. When you limit production of American energy, when you go to kill energy infrastructure like pipelines, when you go and strong arm the financial institutions of this country, which they're doing, saying don't invest in American energy. Oh, by the way, definitely don't invest in American energy in the Arctic, which is called Alaska. This is the result. You now have a comptroller of the currency nominee who has recently said, just a couple months ago in a seminar, part of the policy mix will be to put out of business small oil and gas producers. This is purposeful. And it would be great if you guys could just blatantly ask the White House, are you trying to drive up energy prices on the backs of hardworking Americans? The answer is yes. Listen to the rhetoric, look at their actions, and they're very successful. And they're harming working class families. Here's the final point. This administration is so out of touch with those families. You had the White House chief of staff recently tweet out saying high energy prices, inflation is a, quote, high class problem. What the heck does that mean? The White House press secretary on these issues is starting to look like Baghdad Bob. Some of you might remember him during the first Gulf War. These issues are exploding all around the White House, and they just ignore them like there's nothing happening to working families. You know, the Secretary of Energy has talked about releasing the Strategic Petroleum Reserve. We have a much better idea. There's something in Alaska called the National Petroleum Reserve of Alaska. Tap that. That's what Congress intended it for. And some of you were here 2 weeks ago when we laid out a common sense, all of the above energy plan that can actually reduce emissions, but play to our strengths, which is abundance and export technology in clean burning American natural gas all over the world. That would reduce global emissions while expanding job opportunities, helping our foreign policy. That's the route we need to go. Not crushing American energy and hurting working families.